Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Friday of the 24th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Give peace, O Lord, to those who wait for you, that your prophets be found true. Hear the prayers of your servant and of your people Israel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, teach and urge these things. Whoever teaches something different and does not agree with the sound words of our Lord Jesus Christ and the religious teaching is conceited, understanding nothing, and has a morbid disposition for arguments and verbal disputes. From these come envy, rivalry, insults, evil suspicions, and mutual friction among people with corrupted minds who are deprived of the truth, supposing religion to be a means of gain. Indeed, religion with contentment is a great gain, for we brought nothing into the world, just as we shall not be able to take anything out of it. If we had food and clothing, we shall be content with that. Those who want to be rich are falling into temptation, into a trap and into many foolish and harmful desires, which plunge them into ruin and destruction. For the love of money is the root of all evils, and some people, in their desire for it, have strayed from their faith and have pierced themselves with many pains. But you, man of God, avoid all this. Instead, pursue righteousness, devotion, faith, love, patience and gentleness. Compete well for the faith. Lay hold of eternal life, to which you were called when you made the noble confession in the presence of many witnesses. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Blessed the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Why should I fear in evil days when my wicked ensnareners ring me round? They trust in their wealth, the abundance of their riches is their boast.
Blessed the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Yet in no way can a man redeem himself or pay his own ransom to God. Too high is the price to redeem one's life. He would never have enough to remain alive always and not see destruction.
Blessed the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Fear not when a man grows rich, when the wealth of his house becomes great, for when he dies, he shall take none of it. His wealth shall not follow him down.
Blessed the poor in spirit, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Though in his lifetime he counted himself blessed, they will praise you for doing well for yourself. He shall join the circle of his forebears, who shall never more see light.
Blessed the poor in spirit, the kingdom of heaven is theirs.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus journeyed from one town and village to another, preaching and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom of God. Accompanying him were the 12 and some women who had been cured of evil spirits and infirmities. Mary called Magdalene, from whom 7 demons had gone out, Joanna, the wife of Herod's steward Chusa, Susanna, and many others who provided for them out of their resources. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today, let me propose this for our reflection. No? I think this Gospel is a very, very short, but very beautiful Gospel that somehow gives us an idea of the nature of mission, the nature of Christian mission. No? First, you realize that here, the mission by itself is, and I'll use this word, peripatetic. No? Always moving around, always moving around. So that's the first point that we will reflect on. No? Second is, this Gospel also reminds us, no, that the mission, the Christian mission, is communal. And not only communal, but inclusive, no? An inclusive community, no? And then the third and final point is that the mission also is a mission of shared resources. Again, communal resources, no? And we'll say more about that, no, in our reflections. First, about being peripatetic, no? Here you see, no, as the Gospel tells, he journeyed from one town and village to another, preaching all over, no? Proclaiming the good news, no? And remember in that Gospel of Mark also, remember when he cured many people, expelled demons, and then the following morning he leaves and goes to the mountain to pray. Then his disciples were looking for him and said, let's go back, they're looking for you. But what does Christ say? Remember, this is very early on, no, in his ministry. He said, no, to other towns I must go because I need to proclaim, no? So that is the nature of our mission, no? It is bringing us all over where the need is, where the call is. No, I remember, and I've shared this with you in the past. No, when we were in the seminary, the first 2 years in the novitiate, our lives were ruled by the bell, no, and by a schedule. No, I remember one of our conferences, our spiritual novice master and spiritual director, Father Benny Calpitura, was telling us, you know, the reason why we do that schedule and the bell, because we were told that the moment you hear the bell, leave everything behind, what you're doing, and go on to the next task. No, now, I remember him telling us that is the nature of mission, no? That we are ready to go wherever the mission calls us. And we're ready to leave behind what we are doing if God calls us somewhere else. No, remember what I shared with you when I was enjoying, probably those were the 3 happiest years of my life, no? When I was principal, and then later on, for 2 more years, I was basic education director. I always ask myself, no, because I was enjoying so much, and I think we were doing such a great job together as a community, no. But I always prayed and asked myself, if my provincial tells me to go somewhere else, am I ready to go, and not to hold on to the position, no? Because that's part of mission. That is part of the Jesuit mission or character of mission, no. And that is part of mission in general, no. Are we ready to go, no? Wherever it leads us, to always be moving, no, according to the call of the mission, the peripatetic nature of mission, always on the go, so to speak. As Ignatius's one of his biographies describes it, no, this is what also our novice master tells us, no, that Ignatius lived his life with one foot raised, and he also advised that to the Jesuits, no. To live our lives one foot raised, meaning to say we're ready anytime, anywhere to go, no, when mission calls, no, with one foot raised. The second point is communal and inclusive nature of mission. Here, very beautiful Gospel, no, to describe this. Accompanying Jesus were the 12 and some women who had been cured of evil spirits, infirmities. So he names them, and then they provide for the needs, no? So you realize that even that early, Christ included women in his mission, in his community, no? And not just women, but sinners and tax collectors, no? So they were all part of the community. It was very inclusive, no? And perhaps this is something that we must recapture, no? Number one, to recapture our sense of community. You know, over the weekend, I said Mass with I concelebrated with Cardinal Taglin in the blessing of Sagrada Familia Church in Cubao, in Gateway, no, on top of the Gateway Mall, no. the blessing of the altar, no? And that was what Cardinal Tagle was saying, no? That again, we need to recapture that sense of community, no? And especially to make the youth feel the church's sense of community, no? But I think that is the nature of mission, no? It's communal and it's inclusive, no? And then the third and last point is that, again, part of that communal aspect is the shared resources, no? And you know, when I was a Jesuit, no, what was explained to us is that our poverty, the Jesuit poverty, is communal poverty. That in a sense, you don't own anything, no? That everything belongs to the community. But the other thing also that Ignatius always emphasized was that while it is communal poverty, it is also the resources of the community are always in the service of the apostolate, and always in the service of the works or the mission. So it was a poverty really that was directed towards the apostolates, the apostolic works, no? And I think this is something again that is something to consider, no, as a virtue, no? That we might try to pray for, no? Even though, let's say, people do not have vows, no? But can that be part of the way we use our resources? That our resources really are shared resources. It's almost talking about stewardship, no? That is, it has been entrusted to us, and therefore the trust given is for us to use it, no, for the good of all, no, for the good of creation, for the good of humanity. But that shared resources, a sense of stewardship, no. Siguro maganda na pagnilaya natin itong ebanghelyo ngayong araw, no, na nagbibigay sa atin ng masasabi natin tatlong mahalagang katangian ng misyon, ano. Una sa lahat, ang misyon ay lagi tayong naglalakbay. Kung saan tayo tinatawag ng pangangailangan ng misyon, doon tayo tutungo. Yun yung tinuro sa amin noon sa seminaryo, no? Na kaya yung aming training was pagka schedule namin, pag narinig yung bell, dapat pumunta na sa susunod na activity at iwan yung ginagawa. Sabi, training yan, ano, para kung saan man tumawag ang misyon, agad-agad tutugon, no? At ganun din nung tatrabaho ko bilang principal, enjoy na enjoy ako, no? Kaya lagi kong tinatanong, no? Time and again, tatanungin ko sa dasal ko, pag sinabi ba ng provincial ko, kailangan ako sa ibang lugar, handa ba akong lumakad, no? Susunod na araw. Kasi bahagi yan ng kahulugan ng misyon, ano? Hindi ka humahawak o kumikiling dun sa gusto mo lamang, kundi nasaan yung tawag ng misyon, ano? At yung pangalawang punto nga ay ano, ang misyon ay isang trabaho ng komunidad. At ang misyon ay lahat kasama, no? Nakita natin dito sa komunidad ng Panginoon, kasama ang mga babae, kasama ang mga makasalanan, ang mga tax collectors, na siya ay isang komunidad at isang ano, no, inclusive. At yung pangatlo, yung punto ng misyon ay yung pagbabahagi, no, ng mga masasabi natin resources o ng pera at pangangailangan, na bahagi rin yan ng kagandahan ng pagiging isang komunidad sa misyon. Na siguro mauugnay natin to sa stewardship, ano, na pinagkatiwala sa atin, para sa ano, no, para sa trabaho sa kaharian ng Diyos. So ngayong araw pag nilaya natin ang ano, ang mga katangian ng misyon, sapagkat mahalaga na muli natin tong maunawaan at maisabuhay sa ating pang-araw-araw na buhay as we live out our mission. Full of hope and confidence, we make our prayer to God the Father, anxious for an increase of His presence in our life.
That the Church may continue to grow and be a symbol of justice, love, and truth in the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as a community, we may not be idle in our life of faith, but every day seek God, even in our difficulties and trials, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That children may grow in the ways of grace and mature into Christ-like people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that what each is offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate His death. With living faith we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly serve and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago and to which succeeding generations offer their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes all, so Filipinos may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Help of all Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat. Ay, sorry ho, nakalimutan kong banggitin kahapon yung Proyekto Pilipino. Magandang episode this weekend. Again, it's about nutrition, but this time it's focusing on the challenge of the proper nutrition. No? So it's a very good discussion. Very sometimes gets technical, but it gives us a better understanding of the challenges. No, so please join us for Proyekto Pilipino. And our guest is Associate Professor Kim De Liliana from the UP, no? The UP Department of Nutrition and Public Health. No? That's right, the College of Public Health. And then also for Journeys of Hope this weekend, we have one of our love teams in ABS, Kobe and Andy. It's going to be a two-part. That's for next week. But this weekend, we have... a great, very great dancer, no, from the Philippine High School of the Arts. Please join us to listen to the story of Clark, and he will share with us his journey. And then we're going to show some clips of his dance. So please join us this weekend for Journeys of Hope. Marami pong salamat, and have a good day ahead. Have a good weekend ahead. Thank you very much.
Mapataliserya man o tunay na buhay, hindi dapat nananaig ang kasamaan sa kabutihan. Bawat Pilipino dapat nabubuhay ng malaya, payapa at masagana. Hindi rin tayo dapat matakot na ipahayag ang ating mga hinaing at ipaglaban ang ating mga karapatan. Wala dapat naaapi at dapat lahat ay nagtatamasa ng kapayapaan at katarungan.
True ally kapwa para sa katarungan at kapayapaan. Caritas Philippines upholds justice and peace as essential element of faith in action. Meron tayong mga programa, lalo na edukasyon para sa kamulatan ng ating mga mamamayan sa kanilang karapatan at tungkulin, dokumentasyon sa karahasan at paglabag sa karapatang pangtao, legal services para tugunan at buwagin ang mga di makatarungang kalakaran at istruktura sa lipunan na nagdudulot ng walang kapayapaan tulad ng red tagging, extrajudicial killing, harassment, corruption, pag-agaw ng lupa sa mga magsasaka at mga katutubo at iba pa.
Nagsasagawa ang Caritas Philippines ng mga konsultasyon at orientasyon ukol sa Justice and Peace Program sa iba't ibang lugar sa Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Sinusubaybayan din natin ang takbo ng ating programa sa mga lugar na ito.
Katarungan at kapayapaan sa bawat isa. Ito ang ating alay kapwa.